ذل كل شيء لعظمته وخضع. الله الذي أمسك السماء فرفع، وهو الذي بسط الأرض فأوسع، وهو الذي فجر الأنهار فأنبع، وهو الذي أنزل الغيث فهمع، وهو الذي أنشأنا وأنشأ جميع البشرية من نفس واحدة فمستقر ومستودع. ونصلي ونسلم على سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. يقول صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم: أنا خطيب الناس يوم القيامة إذا وفدوا، وأنا مبشرهم إذا أيسوا، وأنا شفيعهم إذا حبسوا. لواء الحمد يومئذ بيدي، وأنا سيد ولد آدم ولا فخر. صلى الله عليه وسلم. My dear brothers, it's a must in khutbah to start with praising of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Knowing Allah by heart, having the heart influenced by Allah and His mighty Jalla Jalaluhu, change our life. That's why scholar says it's a must to talk about taqwa, the fear of Allah, the awareness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is taqwa ra'sul amru kulluhu. Fearing Allah and being aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the head of every affairs. Because if you're aware of Allah, you will act proper. He's with you. What has been or drawn us to mistakes and to troubles and not acting properly is because the awareness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes away from our heart. That's why Allah said in the Quran, ذَلِكُمْ ظَنُّكُمْ الَّذِي ظَنَنْتُمْ بِرَبِّكُمْ أَرْدَاكُمْ. This is indeed your faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you're not being aware of Allah. This is the reason that you have fallen into mistakes and you disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes if the doors are closed and nobody's with us, and we tend to do a mistake, if a child comes, we fear a child. If a person comes, we fear him. How about being aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that have his, our sustenance, that our life is in his hand, that everything around us is by his blessing and his mercy. So being aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a must for a Muslim in order to live a proper life and to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And my brothers, the khutbah today, it is about the rule of our masjid to build our community. What's the purpose that we invest in making our masajids? The first thing that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did when he came to the Medina, he established the masjid. The masjid was the place that changed the life of Sahaba. And the Medina used to call Yathrib. Then later on, after establishing the Amal of the Masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it was termed as Al-Madina Al-Munawwara, the lightened city. Lightened with what? Lightened with the Amal. Lightened with the Masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have to understand that all of us, every one of us, has two fortunes. You have two fortunes. One fortune is that we gained by working. We gained the land, we gained our business. This is a fortune. And you know where we take it from those people that lived before us. Another fortune that's very valuable is the fortune of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The deen, the iman that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam invested in our life. It was narrated that Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu arda left out of the masjid to the market, and he called into people, "Oh, people of the market, you're here, and the fortune of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the heritage of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, is being divided in the masjid, distributed among others." So when they heard the news, all of them closed the shops and they rushed to the masjid. When they reached the masjid, he saw, he's looking for things to be distributed, material gain to be distributed. They don't find anything. So they returned back to Abu Huraira. I said, "Oh Abu Huraira, you told us that the heritage of Rasulullah, the fortune that Rasulullah has left, is being divided in the masjid." There was nothing. He said, "What did you find there?" They found people reciting Quran, people in ta'aleem, some people in dhikr of Allah. He said, "This is the fortune that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have left for you. And anyone who takes this fortune, takes this life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the teaching of iman, he will supersede in this dunya and the akhirah." All of us, my dear brothers, are suffering from a lot of diseases in our hearts. We want to work on this, because the way to influence in the society around us is only if we have the manners and the behaviors and the character of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the way that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made a change in the society. And if we inculcate the conduct of Rasulullah, the character of Rasulullah, the teaching of Rasulullah from our masjid, we'll be making a change in the society. We will be making change in our life. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us in so many hadith how important it is to change our conduct with others. We wonder, all of us, who is the closest to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and who is the most beloved to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? In one hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us who is the most beloved to him, and he told us also who is the closest to him in the Day of Judgment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us this honor to be loved by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to be close to him. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Aqrabukum minni manzilatan yawm al-qiyamah wa ahabbakum ilayhi." Aw qala, "Ahabbakum ilayhi," the most beloved among you to me, and the closest to me in the Day of Judgment, "Ahasinkum akhlaqa," the best of you in manners, subhanAllah, is those who's the closest to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Those are the most beloved to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We wonder, maybe the one who makes more hajj, one who makes more salat, pray all night. No, it is that character that has so good heart, that has so good conduct, he will be the closest to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Another hadith the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us about, and my dear brothers, in this world, matters, material things weigh. But salah, does salah weigh? No, we prayed Fajr salat, but it doesn't have a scale to weigh it. Smile does not have a weight. If you recite the Quran or make the tasbih, or you act properly, does this have a weight? No. Materialism weigh, material things. But in the Day of Judgment, things will be shifted. All these big mountains that we see will turn to ashes, as Allah described in the Quran. Materialism will have no weight at all. But what will be weighed in your scale in the Day of Judgment is it's your a'mal. So to be smart, how can we harvest from this world these a'mal that will be weigh so much in our scale? The smartest of us is this one that invests in a very little gold, little things, he gain a lot that will weigh a lot in his scale in the Day of Judgment. And what's this a'mal? Rasulullah described to us, "Athqal shay fi mizan al-abd yawm al-qiyamah," the heaviest thing that you could harvest from this world in the Day of Judgment, what is it? حسن الخلق, to have a good character, a good ikhlaq. So these are the values of this ikhlaq. These are the values that we should cultivate in our life. And the question for us is how can we change? How can we make a change in our life? Because sometimes a person would say, "I get upset very quickly. This is my attitude. This is how I am." Al-Imam al-Ghazali said, if a person cannot change his attitudes, his ikhlaq, his behavior, if the human being does not change, cannot change, then there is no point of sending the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. There is no point of descending the Quran, because the message of Anbiya, the message of the Quran, would change humanity, conduct, and ikhlaq, and mu'asharat. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لُؤْتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. that I am sent for you to complete the akhlaq of your life. Allah in the Quran said, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Scholar says, how to conceal between the hadith and the ayah? The ayah says that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent a blessing for humanity. And the hadith said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent to complete the good akhlaq, the good manners in life of humanity. They said a society or a community, that love exists among them, that forgiveness is among them, that good behavior among them is a society that's blessed. And a society or a community that is hatred, jealousy, envy spread among them, this society is not derived from the rahmah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the way we should inculcate the akhlaq of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in our life, and how important is this if we conduct and we behave in a way that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam have taught us to be. This is a means of guidance of humanity. One time I met a scholar from India, and he said, my means of guidance is because of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam trip to At-Taif when he was stoned. SubhanAllah. I know that the Indo-Pakistan area was embraced Islam by expedition of Muhammad ibn al-Qasim al-Thaqafi. He's the one and the youth from Thaqif who led that expedition. So how is related to the trip that Rasulullah made to the Taif? He said, when Rasulullah sallam, after they stoned him and the blood come out of him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he went out and he made his dua. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given the choice to squeeze these people with the mountains, but the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with a good behavior, not a revenge sort of behavior, but rahmah, he said, oh Allah, Allah might bring out of their progeny that will take this Islam. And from their progeny comes Muhammad ibn al-Qasim, that was a means of guidance to all these people. So the good behavior comes to results. Even Rasulullah sallam, and all of you know the story of Zayd ibn Su'na, that's unique in the Torah. He was a Jewish rabbi, read in the Torah the signs of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And he said, there's only one missing, that when you increase your ignorance against him, and rough against the Prophet, his love increases, his good behavior increases. Just like you burn the oud. When you burn the oud, what happens? You burn it more, it gives more smell. This was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he tried to test for that. He came very aggressive and said bad word to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, till the point that Umar took the sword and he was stopped. But Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Umar, no Umar, you should ask me to be kind and honest in returning back the loans, and you should ask him to ask politely. All of us need the advice. And then he told him to give him, and to give him more, because he has feared, he has made him afraid. This is the conduct that after this story, this Zayd ibn Su'na radiallahu ta'ala anhu Allah became a Muslim. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us that good manners changes the society around us. And we, my dear brothers, only we are protected if only this society, not we by building big houses and places, but by influencing the society we're living in. We see how Islam spread, and still until today will continue until the day of judgment in the life of Malaysian and Indonesian. And we see how Islam was done in Spain. Because with good character, good conduct, with having our mercy and working in others, we can make a change in the society. And the question for us, how can we bring the change in our life? How can we bring the change in the society, our society? This is where the role of our masjid, how to come forth. This is the purpose that we are trying to establish our masjid, so we can make the changes in our life and make the changes in the society around us. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لكم ولي أستغفره إنه هو الغفور. الحمد لله وكفى وصلى الله تبارك وتعالى على عباده الذين اصطفى. One scholar was asked, you know, in our today, the non-Muslims have made a lot of advances in all kind of science. And he asked, what Islam has made, kind Muslims have made out of advances. The scholar returned, you know, very beautiful answer. When he was asked the question, he said that we manufacture planes, we have factories for whatever. What Muslim do have? So he said, we have a factory that you bring wolves and tigers, and in the other end, they come as human beings. SubhanAllah. I one time met a brother in Baltimore downtown, and I saw this brother, mashallah. He has a black color, but the light of Iman is coming out of his face. SubhanAllah. If you look at him, you want to stay with him. And when he told me about his story that he was in a drug abuse. He had so much trouble and problems. He even went to prison several times. But SubhanAllah, what made this man? And what changed this man to this character? It is our masajids that make a change in our society. And if we invest in our masajid, we will see the changes also in our life. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when people sit and gather for ta'lim, four things descend upon them: the rahmah of Allah, the angels, the sakina. What is the sakina? We blow, sometimes they tell you, be aware, be far from the x-ray. We don't see the x-ray. But there is. The sakina is a nur from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know that the spectrum light, the visible light, is just a little bit of it. But there is other lights. So the angels of Allah is also nur. So when we sit in this gathering, we see the changes in our life. Sometimes we bring to a big incubators. What do? We put eggs and we change four things: the light, the temperature, the humidity, and the wind. By changing these things around, the eggs, from death, they come to life. So by changing these things around us, we would change our society. We will come to the ikhlaq of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that's why it's important that we should invest in our masajid. Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, يَتْبَعُ الْمَيِّتْ ثَلَاثٌ. What followed the dead is three: أَهْلُهُ وَمَالُهُ, his family and his wealth. And the third is his good, his a'mal, what he had invested his life in. Then he said, the Sahasim said, two return back and one will go with him. For how long life? 20 years, 30 years, billion and billions and billions of years. of this area is filled of Simsimi seed. Simsimi seed is very small. If all heavens and earth is filled with Simsimi seeds, and a bird comes every 1,000 years, eat one and go. For 1,000, come back, eat another one. This will finish. But still, the people of paradise will enjoy it, continue. And the people will still dwell in hellfire for eternity. So the investment that we should do is more in our masajid. Another hadith, the Rasulullah ﷺ wants to illustrate this fact and bring it to our hearts stronger. He said, a person laid in the bed waiting for death, and he looked around him. Around him is three brothers. So he said to his first brother, "Brother, I need you. I have a trial that I will go to, the trial of the grave. I have a trial that I will go into. And if I succeed in this trial, I'll be happy my entire life. So I need you to come with me to this trial." He said, "No, I cannot. The moment you depart out of this door, I will not be with you." The Prophet ﷺ turned to the Sahaba and said, "What do you think of this brother?" He said, "Bi'sa al-akh ya Rasulullah." What a worst brother, oh Rasulullah. He said, "This is the wealth." Then he turned back to the second brother. He said, "Oh my brother, I have invested on you. I have went forth and back for you. I have a trial. This is my trial. If I succeed, I'll pass. And I will succeed for my forever. I need you. I want you." He said, "I am here for you. I will take you to the door. When I throw you there, I'll go." He said, "No, I want you to be with me." He said, "I cannot." He said, "What do you think of this brother?" He said, "Oh, bi'sa al-akh ya Rasulullah. What a worst brother is this." Then he said, Rasulullah ﷺ turned to the last brother and he said, "I need you. I have worked for you, but this is the moment I need you. Those have let me down. This is a trial. After it is a success, and this success is internal success." He said, "I am for you here because the good deeds defend for you in this life. Sana'i' al-ma'roof taqi masari' al-su. And I am for you in the road and inside the trial. I will stand for you until I save you." He said, "What do you think of this brother?" He said, "This is the best brother." And the question for you, oh brothers, how much of our time and our energy we have spent for the first brother and for the second brother and for the third? It does not mean that we neglect our families or our wealth. If we have a proper intention, it's all investment for Akhirah, inshallah. But we need to invest also in deen, in iman, in Islam, in Akhirah. And alhamdulillah, Allah blessed us with this masjid, and Allah blessed us with people that are very active, and they did their best to make it happen. So inshallah, tomorrow we have a big event. In this event also, the two senates will come into this event for us, and as well as the governor and also the congressman. So no state in all the United States that have collected all these good figures as much as those brothers have done in this society. And we want to show them that we're here. Their purpose is to come and say, "Muslims, we are with you. We are with the Muslims," especially in today's society. It's a shame that we don't show up in a moment that we needed to show up, because Rasulullah ﷺ said in hadith, "Rahim Allahum ra'an arahum minna quwwah." Sometimes the brother says, "Hey, please ask dua for me." I said, "Well, how about Rasulullah will make dua for you?" "How?" He said, Rasulullah said, may Allah bless those who have showed the strength of Muslims. So this is a moment that we have to show that we are strong. We have to show we are more. We have to make an influence in the society that we live in. And we want all of the brothers to be here. And not all of you, but each one take responsibility to make da'wah and bring several, inshallah. So to make this event profitable to us and to make a changes in our society. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq, inshallah. All of us, inshallah, to make that event succeeded, inshallah. And to give our time and our wealth to establish Islam, establish the masjid. That will be a point of change for the society and inshallah for the whole world if we invest in this masjid more, inshallah. Allahumma salli wa sallam wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent blessing upon the prophets, he said, Salamun ala al-mursaleen. Salam ala al-mursaleen. Salamun ala Musa wa Harun. Salam upon Musa and Harun. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came to make blessing and salam upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Inna Allah. He started with himself. وَأَثْنَى بِهِ عَلَى مَلَائِكَتِهِ. And the second, and he said, and his angels. The angels of Allah. One more time, Allah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَنَ النَّبِيِّ. And he came with the presence. يُصَلُّونَ means continuously making salat upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Then he called all of us, make salat in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli wa sallam wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa radallahum an sadatana Aba Bakr wa Umar wa Uthman wa Ali wa an baqiyat al-mubashirin min al-jannah wa an al-Hasan wa al-Husayn wa Fatimah al-Zahra wa rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma inna nas'alaka al-huda wa al-tuqa wa al-afaf wa al-ghina ya hayy ya qayyum bi rahmatika nastaghith wa min adhabika nastajir aslih lana sha'nana kullah ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين إن تكلنا إلى أنفسنا تكلنا إلى ضعف وعورة وذنب وخطيئة. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم إن أحوالنا وأحوال الإسلام وأحوال المسلمين في كل مكان لا تخفى عليك يا أرحم الراحمين. أحوال المسلمين في سوريا وفي فلسطين وفي اليمن وفي كل البلاد لا تخفى عليك. نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم احفظنا فوق الأرض وتحت الأرض ويوم العرض برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعل الحق اللهم اجعل اجتماعنا غدا سبب النصرة والبركة إن شاء الله وأقم لنا هذا المسجد برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروا على ما زدكم من نعم. الله يذكركم. صلى الله عليه وسلم.
My brother, please, right in front of the door, leave the space for the latecomer. Sometimes when they come, they don't find the place to come in. They try to come in, but there's no place.